Well, guys, it was my first death right there. And I have to try to find out how the fuck I got down there. Unfortunately, I didn't get it. Actually, you can see I had over 32,000 score there. That was my very first death in this world. We'll check all the time stats afterwards. But right now, I'm a little bit more worried about getting my stuff, because all of those tools took easily over 30 hours of grinding to get. And I had plenty of shit on me as well. So I'm going to attempt... No. I'm going to attempt to find my way back down there as best as I can. I know I found my way down by going through... There was a ravine that I sort of went down. No. I won't break through anything unless I know it's where I need to be going. I'm gonna be really upset here if I can't find this. It was in a ravine. I remember these here. I didn't go around them though, did I? Maybe I did. Oh, here's a ravine. There it is! Okay, that's all the water. Yep. I'll tell my whole story after I get my shit. Right now I'm more worried about not dying again. Oh my god, I'm going to die again. Oh my god, ouch. I think I can get to my stuff. I see my stuff! Holy Jesus, holy Jesus. Yeah, but don't worry, I'll... I gotta put this shit on. Oh, of course, the one thing I couldn't pick up was my fucking diamonds. Why can't I... Okay, well, I'll just throw that away because it's weaker. Sucks, guys. That really sucks. We'll have to leave that shit down here. Golden apple is all that's left. 1 second, let me do this. I'll grab that golden apple. Alright, let's, you know what? I'm just gonna do this. To get me out of here. I try not to do this now, but it kind of defeats the whole purpose of why I came down here. Actually, all of this is in... I'm really fucking bummed out right now, but, I mean, the first death was going to happen at some point, and the way it happened was really stupid, too. That's the thing that gets me. Oh, good, now that's going to be a pain in the freaking ass to deal with. I'll tell my story once I feel safe. Alright, now let me just get the fuck out of here. The whole reason I came down here into this cave was to repair my pickaxe, because it has mending on it. So, if I came down and was mining up diamonds and redstone and stuff, it would give me the XP and coal. And I did. I basically almost fully repaired the thing. I should have made sure I grabbed everything. I did. Okay. I didn't know it would lead to my first death. And talk about a bummer right there. Alright, this should be good enough. Alright, we're in the middle of... I know where we are. We just do this. Alright, let's get back home. and then I'll kind of try to set the scene of what happened. It was really fucking dumb what happened. Oh, I realize that there's something I must have lost down there, because I don't have it in my inventory. It looks like I don't have my shield anymore. It looks like I have everything else but my shield. I don't know if I missed it or if it must have fallen in like a one block hole or something. I don't know. Oh, man, I'm so bummed out. We've gone so long in this world without a death. Although I am happy that I'm documenting it. Even though I didn't get to document the death itself, you could at least see from the death screen on. And the only reason I couldn't really spend time is because I didn't really know how I got down there. I think I got really lucky finding my way back down there. But, that's why I was in a kind of a rush, because I didn't want my stuff to despawn. I was mostly worried about my tools, all of this stuff here. All of these things are super, super important to me. And my armor, which I haven't really shown off too much yet over here. I should have put this stuff on. This would have made me nigh invincible. And of course, I'm saving it for the Nether, which is what this was all in preparation for. Repairing, so I repaired my bow, which was almost broken. I was grinding levels. Thankfully, I didn't have like 60 levels like I had before. Thankfully, I only had like maybe, I don't know, 20 or so. That's easy enough to get back. So here's what happened. Basically, there was a mine shaft down there at bedrock level, and it was a ravine that was partially filled in with water. You could see that I was able to walk around without the water. Well, right where all my stuff was, right, was right in the pit, was right in one of the mine shafts. Well, just above that mine shaft, like literally, I'm not kidding, two blocks up there, there's a little small opening, which is like the edge of the ravine. And this small little platform, and then two blocks down is the mine shaft that you would go down, right, where I died in. Well, I went up there to light it up, to clear out the area, because there was some enemies. There was a skeleton and a zombie. The skeleton hit me, I killed it, then the zombie fell from the ceiling, and I heard a spider, and then I got hit from the zombie, and so I was like, okay, well, it's time to turn around and run back to the mine shaft where it's narrow and I'm safe. And then at the same moment, a creeper fell from above behind me and exploded. Because for some reasons, when creepers take fall damage, they explode instantly. It happened with Vanilla in one of those earlier clips we saw, in one of the earlier episodes. But it exploded behind me, but it didn't kill me. But it launched me into the mineshaft with only one heart left, and I took fall damage from only two blocks high. And that's what killed me. Fucking fall damage killed me. Technically, the creeper killed me, but what does it say? It just says I hit the ground too hard. See, I was blown by the creeper into the mineshaft, and then it killed me that way. And I was just... Let's go to statistics here and see how long I lived without dying in this particular run. It should say in here. Right there. 4.71 days I survived in this world before I ended up dying. Where does it list deaths? Yeah, number of deaths right there, one. I'm just opening the calculator because I don't exactly know how to do math when it's 11:36 and I haven't fucking slept yet. Well, 4.71 days, that would be... That's almost 100, that's like 110 hours worth of playtime before I died. Now, I know that, of course, there are people with hardcore playthroughs that have survived, like, I don't know, how many in-game days have I survived? You can actually find out if you go to F3. It's day 498 in the actual world here. I know that there are some hardcore, like, survival worlds that are 800 plus days going. But I'd say 498 days before my first death, nearly 120 hours played before my first death. I'm pretty satisfied with that. I think that's the best I've done in recent history. but it still sucks that it had to happen that way. Something so simple is what ended up killing me. Just a small little fall. To be fair, I was blown across the thing. I have no idea what happened to armor. I'm not joking when I say that I feel like armor has been, like, iron armor is weaker than it was before. I don't know if that's intentional, but I take so much damage from everything. But regardless, it is what it is. It's been documented, and, well, in the next set, down here, when Vanilla Log's back on today, we're gonna go to the Nether for the first time, and I'll record that too. Yeah, this is a whole new part of the base that I've been working on. But, down in here, there is the way to the Nether room or whatever. Then I'm probably gonna don my diamond armor. Got my bow, which is repaired. The only thing I wanted to get, like, my sword and shovel repaired too, but get a load of this. Look at how much it costs. It's 32 fucking... Look at that. It's 32 levels just to repair it with... Just to repair a chunk of it. So I think what I'll have to do is probably make a diamond sword and a diamond shovel and then save up the levels to repair. Because this is ridiculous. But, yeah.